traffic congestion is kind. And by recognizing traffic conditions and probing into congestion patterns, city administrators could get a better picture of how current traffic runs and gain insights into the issue of traffic congestion. It will definitely help not only in daily management of traffic and generation of short-term traffic control procedures, but also in medium and long-term city infrastructure planning, tuning, and public service provisioning. SAP Smart Traffic helps city traffic run better.
Okay, so you have seen one of the real cases that we implemented in one city in China. But what I would like to take you through in this presentation is how we position this solution and where this solution is coming from. So how it is mentored together, how it is combined together, where we are using our data. First important thing by such solution is to gather really the real data from the any type of possible data generators that exist outside in the world. And if you see on the left side, you have people who have some mobile phones, who have some any type of applications or devices which can send some info to the central traffic organization. Another which is important is from the vehicles. Vehicles have their GPS systems. They have these GPS systems have this data collected. For example, GPS navigation system. They can share with you the data about the vehicles, and all this data should be collected in a suitable smart platform where we can analyze this data to get some potential visible insight into the situation inside of the city. And then last but not least, you are getting the data from the infrastructure. From the infrastructure, I mean, you have induction loops in the city. You have traffic lights, you have video cameras, you have maybe some beacons where you can detect how the people are moving, how the vehicles are moving. And all this information can get into one suitable platform and collecting them, have a great history of this data, which is extremely important, because with the history you can predict and you can get some good insights. So what we are trying to do is, data is crucial dimension to build this solution, and what we are trying to do is to transform from a model where you have a kind of model for the ITS system in the city to a dynamic, big data driven model of this ITS system, because this is a dynamic and proactive, and this is the reason why we are looking for such, let's say, solution where we can leverage all these data which are coming from the outside world and somehow seamlessly present to the city operator or the city operation center. The concept where we are looking for the sub-smart traffic solution is that first, what is extremely important on the left is that we have the real-time integration with every type of sensors data that exists outside. More data that we have, better analytics we can do, better visualization we can do, better detection of the traffic we can have. More of them, it is extremely important. Then, next thing which is important to see is to have a deep data mining with professional analysis tool. So to get some valuable insight of this data, this is extremely important, and this is integrated inside of our platform. Prediction you can get with a large history of this data. So you have to have a kind of structure of this data and patterns of this data for a long period of time, because with this, with analytics, you can do some predictions about the possible situations in the city, how the traffic will be progressing, what will happen, and with this prediction you can even notify the commuters who are on the streets what to do and where to go and how to manage and how to commute inside of this community. On the left side you have what if simulation with this smart traffic. What if simulation means that you can generate some artificial traffic to understand what will happen when the traffic will be exceeding the existing limit, And with this information, and I will show you one use case, with this information you can notify the commuter, maybe to give him a notification, please go from point A to point B 50 minutes before, because with this you can avoid the congestion and you can come faster to the point B which you want to go. Of course you need a powerful GIS engine, which is also included in the solution, just to visualize and to give some kind of operational platform to the traffic operation center, to the traffic operation coordinator. And at the end, last but not least, which is also important, is how to monetize this data which you are collecting. That means how to give access to some startups or some other small companies which are trying to build any type of other solutions which does not exist, but with your traffic data, which you are giving or selling to them for their solution which they want to build. So this is a kind of a structure of our platform for the smart traffic. Our platform is called Intelligent Traffic Management. It has all these things inside. But what I want to emphasize is on the bottom, you have a lot of different type of sensors, from the bus GPS, from the ticketing system for the bus, from the scheduling system of the bus transport agency, from the bus card. You have induction loops, mobile parking lots, a lot of different information, which are not really structured and in the proper format. So this platform is giving you ability to clean this data and put them in the structured format which will be used for the intelligent traffic management platform to get some more valuable insight out of this data. So streaming of data handling is important. Of course, then we have SAP HANA, who is able to operate with all these real-time streaming data. It is an in-memory database and have ability to be extremely fast with the operations on this data. Then you have the analytics, which is also part of the traffic management, and you can get some valuable insight into what the traffic is performing and how it is doing. And then GIS engine, algorithm engine, and user interface framework, which I already told you about the visualization for the traffic coordinator. And at the end, for all the startups and some small companies, open API, how to access this data and how to make some additional results out of this data. Let's go now to some use cases where we managed to do with our smart traffic platform some great results. This is the case which was presented from the video, and it is talking about the smart lunging, where the main goal of the use case which we implemented is lunging is just to get the visibility on the congestion management on the streets. That means to get to the operator who is operating the traffic inside of the city, so-called traffic performance index. Traffic performance index is some kind of calculation between the sort of the road and the speed of the traffic which is going on the road. And based on this index, because on a highway for sure you have higher speed than on the local road. So traffic performance index should combine both values to get you the real insight how the traffic is performing on each road. And based on this result, then the traffic coordinator can do some operation management functions. Like, for example, switching the lanes. He can maybe change the traffic lights, how they will operate just to avoid the congestions. Maybe he can send, through the alert, he can send a rescue unit whether there is an incident or not. So all this information can be visualized and somehow presented on such traffic management operational platform, which is established in the city of Nanjing. And they are using for giving. They have also a small application for the mobile commuters, where they can give them the information about how the city traffic is performing inside of such big city. So this is a kind of integrated operation center. How does it look like? And you can see what in China, for example, all the sensors and all the sources of data exist. They have, for example, in China, on all the license plates, they have RFID on it, which is not the case by us, but they can get this information from the cars. They can get information from the how the people are commuting with the metro lines. They can get from the taxis, because all the taxis have GPS, and they are commuting over the city, and based on their speed, they can detect how the speed or how the traffic is performing inside of the city. Bus passengers, you can see how the people are moving inside of the city. So you can even detect this type of city motion inside of the city. Video cameras are also one source of information. They can give you where you can go to the city, and there is no other entry point. And of course, these bridges can easily be congested with all the traffic which is coming and trying to go into the city. And so with such prediction, of course, for this prediction and early warning, you need a lot of data to be collected into the system. With this, they can again give you the ability about the detection of the early warning, what you should do to avoid the potential congestions trying to commute over the whole city. Data sources, again, taxi GPS and some data from the radar. So, and another solution which is also interesting, it is on one way it is related to the transportation, on another way it is more related to the people. There are pilgrims coming into the Middle East, and you can imagine how many people are on a specific time, on a specific area, and it is difficult to manage all of this moving of the people, of the traffic, of the buses, of the all types of vehicles who are going through this region. And for example, we are trying also to solve the situation there, to give them the ability to predict what will happen when all these people will come to this small area and how they can commute easily to avoid some casualties or some type of incidents which might happen. On the right side, on the bottom, you can see on the picture so-called heat mapping, which is also another interesting feature based on our platform which we can provide. That means all the people have a kind of tracking devices. They have a kind of badges with a tracking device, and we can detect where they are moving inside of the city. So the city who is operating the movement of all these crowds can get real-time information where the people are moving inside of such city. This function is also, for example, very interesting on the airports, because airports are giving, this is giving a great information to the airports where the people are moving through the airport, and of course the areas where more people are, these are the best areas to put, for example, shops or some other types of things where which people will buy or which people will use. So we are coming to the some references which we implemented around the world. Some of these are in China, some of them are in the Europe, some of them are live, like in Nanjing and in Shanghai, just coming into the live production. And then all others are in a type of proof of concept or pilots which we are doing around with a smart traffic platform, smart traffic management platform from SAP. So this is all from my side. If there are any